Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. We thank God again for another privilege to bring the word of the Lord to yours again, that we are still looking at preaching the gospel of the kingdom. We started this yesterday, preaching the gospel of the kingdom and looking at seeking the kingdom of God. We want to quickly tie it up this morning on that issue of seeking the kingdom of God. That's where we want to tie up this morning. That after this, we now trust God that we now begin to look at the kingdom lifestyle, how one can begin to live the kingdom lifestyle. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Now let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you for the opportunity and the privilege to bring your word to our audience this morning again. We pray that you will take control. We pray that you will take over our life, you take over the utterance, you take over everything that will be said and done. You will be the one speaking through me. You will be the one blessing the lives of the people. You will be the one showing us and exalting us, urging us to begin to seek the kingdom of God and to begin to preach the kingdom of God. We pray that we will not just be talkers. We will not just be people who are saying things without practicing. Rather, we'll be doers, we'll be real doers. It will be that we'll be doers of your word. We'll be doers in the name of Jesus. Help us, O God. Let your word have a place in our hearts today, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your word bless our lives today, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I quickly run to our text we have been looking at in Matthew chapter 24 verse 14. We'll quickly look at it. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. That's what we have been looking at. That's the main text to our theme of preaching the gospel of the kingdom. So for preaching the gospel of the kingdom, we must preach the gospel of the kingdom. It's a call on all who have believed, all who are part of the kingdom of God, to preach the kingdom of God so that it can come, so that the master, the owner, the king of the kingdom can come physically on this earth. Hallelujah. So quickly run to our subtopic of seeking the kingdom. Run down there in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33. That's where we are looking at yesterday. He said, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. We pointed yesterday, we stressed it and emphasized it, that the first and foremost thing everyone must do is to seek the kingdom of God. Seeking the kingdom of God, you crave for it, you hunger for it, you long for it, you desire the kingdom of God every day of your life, every moment by moment in your life, morning by morning, minute by minute, you crave for it, because you are now part of the kingdom of God. You have given your life to, you have received Christ into your life. You have submitted yourself to please God, to be in his kingdom. You are born again. You are born of water and of the spirit. You are born again. You are regenerated. You are being saved. You are being transformed in your heart. You are a candidate, a member, a bona fide citizen of the kingdom of God. What next should you do? You don't get into the kingdom and relax. You get into the kingdom and start seeking the kingdom. And remember, I told you that Jesus is the manifestation, is the total embodiment of the kingdom. When we say seeking the kingdom, we are seeking Jesus. You are seeking Jesus, who is the King of the kingdom. I want to quickly tie it up in this section this morning on the need for us to seek the kingdom first and foremost. I told you, when you begin to seek the kingdom of God, every other thing will be added. You don't seek every other thing. You don't seek every other thing. It is Him, the King of the kingdom. It is a fundamental principle in the kingdom of God that you must submit, you must throw your whole, you must pledge your allegiance, you must submit your whole, your totality. That's the only way you can be pleasing unto the King. That's the only way you can be a real member, a bona fide member of the kingdom of God. You can't be in the kingdom and you are running outside. That's what we said yesterday. You can't be in the kingdom and you are running after what the Gentiles seek after. No. You settle down in the kingdom, seek the kingdom with the whole of your heart. You desire the kingdom above every other thing, because the kingdom has its own purpose, its own plan for your life. You place what on the kingdom of God so that you know this, that you understand the weight of the glory of the kingdom of God, and you will not be wayward. Hallelujah. I want to press on that quickly, that when you begin to seek the kingdom of God, the King of the kingdom will tabernacle in your hearts. The King of the kingdom will begin to reign in your life and exercise his rulership, authority over your life. I want you not to misunderstand me here, that when you begin to seek the kingdom of God, you will not walk, you will not farm, you will not do all that. That's not what I mean. When you begin to seek the kingdom of God, all these other things, which is what to eat, what to drink, what to wear, that the Gentiles are seeking after. They wake up in the morning, they are carried away, they are soaked up, they are filled. They are all about them. It's about what to eat, what to wear, and what to drink. This is what the Gentiles are seeking after. They are seeking after the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. No, for you, a citizen of the kingdom, for you that is subjected to the King of the kingdom, you don't seek these things. What he does to you, what the King of the kingdom does to you, what he normally does is that he will add to you, he will add to you his own plan, his own ways, his own wisdom, his own words. He will add to you what he wants you to do. If for you, as you begin to seek the kingdom of God and the King of the kingdom, the plan of God for your life is that you be a medical doctor, he will add it to you. If it is the will of God for you to get married, he will add it to you. It is him that adds to you. You don't seek after these things. The Gentiles, when they wake up in the morning, they seek these things. No, you that is in the kingdom, you don't behave like them. He will add to you these things. You don't seek money. You are not a lover of money. Like Bible said, you know, those who love money, they have damaged their faith. For you, he will add money to you. He will lead you because you have subjected your life to him. He will be the one controlling you. He will be the one guiding you. He will be the one telling you what to do. You must submit totally to his lordship. He must reign supreme in your life. He must reign in your thoughts. He must reign in your mind. He must reign in your emotion. He must reign in your life. He will add to you a godly partner. For what? For his own purpose. He will add to you a good job. For what? So that he will accomplish his own purpose, the purpose of the kingdom of God. So you are not living for pleasure. You are not living for luxury. You are not living for the fleeting vanities of this world. You are living for the King. You are living for the purpose, for the plan, for the desires, and all of the kingdom of God. That's why you seek the kingdom of God. It must be spelled out. Anyone who is a candidate, who is a member of the kingdom of God, must submit totally to the rulership and to the reigning of the King of the kingdom in his life. This is what it means to seek the kingdom of God. This is what it means to be soaked, to be baptized in the kingdom of God. The Spirit of God will come upon you, the Holy Spirit will fill you, will energize you, will equip you, will give you all that you need to fulfill the divine mandate, the mission of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God must be established. He said, let thy will be done on earth. Let thy kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The plans of the kingdom, when you begin to seek the kingdom of God, the will of God, the kingdom of God, the spiritual kingdom of God, as it's operating in heaven, will be coming to play in this earth. It will be coming to play in your marriage. It will be coming to play in your work. It will be coming to play in your family. It will be coming to play in all that you do. Hallelujah. Remember, I told you that the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. These are the things you begin to see in your life as you begin to dwell in the kingdom of God. As you begin to seek the kingdom of God, you begin to see the manifestation of righteousness. You begin to see abundant joy, abundant peace in your life. Hallelujah. So you seek the kingdom of God. You seek Him. As you seek Him, as you desire Him, it will add to you so many things that the Gentiles are seeking after. I told you, the Gentiles, they seek money. They love money. That's why they compromise everything. They can do anything to get money. They can kill to get money. All their desire. Some are even saying they are in the kingdom of God. They are seeking money. They are claimed to be in the kingdom of God. They are professing to be Christian. They say they are in the kingdom of God. But all that they are seeking is money. Mammon. It is him that you are seeking, the king of the kingdom, that will add money to your life. The things he's going to do as you seek him will amaze you. It will direct you in all the things that you will do through your life that will please him. Hallelujah. So I need to quickly mention this to you so that we can tie it up there, that desire the kingdom of God, seek when you're thinking, in your meditation, in your devotions, in your prayers, as you seek the Lord in your prayers, as you pray, Lord, let thy kingdom come in my life. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You are crying and hungering for the righteousness of God. He said, blessed are those who hunger and seek after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Hallelujah. We hunger and seek after righteousness. We hunger for these things. We hunger for the manifestation of the kingdom of God in our life. We trust God this morning as we bring this short exhortation to you, that God will begin to help you to begin to adjust your life, to live this life of seeking the kingdom of God. Because if you are not a seeker of the kingdom of God, you cannot be a preacher of the kingdom of God. Men who go about preaching heresy, preaching error, preaching mammon, sermonized mammon, they are men who claim to be in the kingdom, but they are seeking the things of the Gentiles, the things that unbelievers seek. That is setting them on rat race every time. Is what has become the chiefest pursuit of their life. Is what has become the principal focus, the principal desire and aspiration and ambition of their life. But when you are a seeker of the kingdom of God, you will suddenly discover that the king of the kingdom will begin to add to your life its own plan, its own purpose. You will be for him a missionary. You will take his own plan and purpose. It will post you. It will place you. It will do all the biddings of the kingdom. And as such, you will be a preacher of the kingdom of God. It's not a one-time affair. It's a continuous thing that you must keep seeking. You must tag yourself. You must label yourself. Say, I am a seeker of the kingdom of God. I am a man who desires the kingdom of God all through my life. I am a citizen. I am a member, a bona fide member of the kingdom of God. I pray and I trust God with you that you will not seek other things. You will not be living claiming to be born again and you are seeking other things. Your seeking will be the kingdom of God. Your seeking will be the king of his kingdom, will be Jesus and him crucified. You will seek to do all that is in his mind. As you seek him in the place of prayer, you will seek to do. That's my prayer for you. And I pray that God will help you as you take time to listen to this message over and over again and pray over it. As you keep doing this, God will be delivering you from sin, from Satan, and from the system of this world. Men who are seekers of the kingdom are men who are disengaged from the world system. The world system have no hold on them. They are people who are pleasing God all the days of their life. Let us pray. Our Father, we want to thank you this morning once again for our viewers, for all those our friends and family who are following. We are pleading before you, all those who are born again, who are born of water and of the Spirit, and they didn't understand this thing, and they are seeking other things. They are seeking what the Gentiles are seeking. I pray for them this morning that you begin to reset their priorities. You begin to make them understand that what they need to seek for their living, for their dying, must be the kingdom of God. They will be seekers of the kingdom of God. They will be people who plunge their life to go in the way of the kingdom. They will place what on the kingdom of God so that they will receive the weight of the glory of the kingdom and they will not be wayward. I pray for them that, Lord, you will impress this upon their heart. I pray as men who are tied up, who are locked up, who are in bondage to the system of this world, many, Lord, you will loose them and release them to serve the purpose of the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that you will release, you will set from every shackles and everything that has tied their life to unnecessary unbelievers Gentile seeking. Lord, you will release them and set them free from pursuing fleeting vanities. Thank you, Father, this morning. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I trust that you have been blessed this morning. I pray that God will give you the grace to continue with us in God bless you.